Hello there, my name is Apocalypse Hero, professional card shark in Balatro, and I pondered what are the actual odds of drawing any particular hand and how can I change that. So these are the hands of Balatro, part one. Possibly. Also just poker trivia, I guess. Similar to the last time I did mathematics regarding cards, I decided that making a simulator and actually just doing the task over 1 million times and taking the average is far easier than trying to understand the math behind the madness. Keep in mind that all of these odds are based off of drawing 8 cards, starting off with an 100% chance of having a high card, meaning that a high card-based strategy is the pinnacle of reliability, completely disregarding the efficacy. Now, going down in order of probability, a 2 of a kind is around 89% likely, meaning that 8 out of every 9 hands will have it. Then, being the third most common hand type is 2 pair, with a drastically lower but still high 44% chance of being drawn. Next, 3 of a kind once again drastically lowers the odds, being only 12% likely to be drawn, followed by a straight, which has a 10% chance of being drawn. And surprisingly, next is flush, with a 7% chance of being drawn, which feels a little counterintuitive considering there are so many numbers compared to colors, but if you think about it, every time you go for a flush and draw a card for it, you are less likely to get another of that suit since you just drew one. But on the other hand, you are more likely to get numbers you haven't already drawn for a straight since there are less of the ones you have now. Moving on is full house, with a 6% chance of being drawn, being significantly harder than getting a 2 pair because of the previously mentioned scaling difficulty in getting a suit and or number that you have removed from the deck, with the first copy of a card being a 4-52, then the following being a 3-52, and so on. Even harder than 3 of one and 2 of another is 4 of a single, having a 0.3% chance of being drawn. And finally, 5 of a kind, being literally impossible to draw with the base deck since there are only 4 of any particular card, which took me a lot longer than I'd like to admit to remember, as I spent a while trying to bug fix this one in my code because I was getting 0.00000000000 and assumed it was an error of some kind. Now, how do we change these odds? First and foremost is hand size. Decreasing or increasing the cards drawn can drastically affect the odds of receiving the cards you want. Keep in mind that the effects of hand size are proportional to the base odds of getting the hand in the first place, with the hand size drastically affecting low odds hands while not really bothering common hands, with a median reduction of around 53% by going from 8 cards drawn to 7. An 80% reduction when going down to 6, and finally a 95% reduction when going down to 5, where honestly anything other than 2 of a kind is more of a pipe dream than anything. Though increasing the hand size from 8 to 9 increases the odds by a median of 80%, going to 10 increases it by 210%, and going to 11 increases it by 350%, which sounds phenomenal until you realize that it has little effect on common hands, and even increasing the 4 of a kind odds by multiplying it by 5 turns a 0.3% chance to a 1.5% chance, which is still something I wouldn't gamble on. Making the medium grade hands where altering hand size really matters, turning the odds of something like a flush from a 7% chance to a 35% chance, meaning hand size is a great avenue if you're going for flushes, straights, full houses, or 3 of a kind. But generally, more hand size is always nice. And most importantly, the odds decrease at a higher proportion to raising, meaning gaining hand size to counteract a possible manacle is nice. A more drastic approach is altering the deck to suit your needs, which in the case of X of a kind, increasing the quantity of a select groupings of ranks is the way to go. So you select, say, 6 out of the 13 ranks and add as many of those as you can, while removing as many of the others as possible, with adding cards having a higher efficacy than removing cards. Though for straights, until you start closing on having 5 ranks where straights are highly likely, there really is no reason to alter the deck, and very little actual effect. Finally, you can also change ranks to assist with flushes, typically prioritizing 2. Once again, another high investment, high return. Though, especially with flushes and straights, the effort spent increasing the odds might be better spent increasing the rewards. That's all for this Balatro video. If you like this and want to see a part 2 where I go further into the details, especially regarding discarding, jokers, and tipping points, then please let me know. For now though, enjoy these beautiful moments I had while playing Balatro. Thank you.
Thank you.